Okay, now we go for the day one part five since we are already at 3:26. And it's continued from part four. HLM6 software run and the first important aspect of computations. It's unconditional model. One way another with random group effect. And the simplest model, no independent, continuous independent variable of x in level one, which is no slope, only intercept. And that's the model we run. We ignore the treatment effect, that's why it's simplest. And only look at the teacher level two difference, y as all individual score. And the level one is 1,000 students. And here, it needs to be one more zero here. Each teacher teaches 100 students, and we have 10 teachers. And that's ANOVA model. So we don't have any treatment effect, no color difference. So it's gonna be just like that. It's awkward, but we needed to get the foundation first. And again, this is a notation that you start to see. Hope you get used to. Level one, individual. Level two, group. That's what you want to remember. And a Y score, B0 group mean plus error. Those two are both error level two, but we have a different notation. So this, the level one is R, but the level two is U. In the keywords, when you go for the complicated models, you don't want to really miss this concept. Well, I'll give you this misconcept. You cannot run complicated model. So unconditional is random effect. Teachers, therapists, school differences. I guess he explained that a lot more. And you now know a lot more about it. But this is just example that you are able to picture as what it is. And a conditional, fixed effect, for instance, gender, treatment. And now, procedure start. You will begin with a blank screen. And why? We always specify what's why. In this case, it's very straightforward why. But when you see the actual data, like it's going to be mathematics score or whatever it is, it's considered as an outcome. So I'll click here and choose as an outcome variable. That's the start point.
Is the plus 5 analysis supposed to use the ANOVA data that we've been working with, or is it our own data that we generate?
Okay, I can explain this again. So we generate the ANOVA, hierarchical ANOVA data, right?
Yeah.
But we ignore the treatment. So, sure, like when you get the data from somewhere else, like you see like a bunch of the things. You know, like the gender, age, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But always when we want to go back to the simplest model, which is we only pick up the data, extract the data what you really want to run. So we ignore the treatment effect this time. So that's why it becomes just like that. We generate the hierarchical ANOVA model that we run as an ANOVA. That's basically all about it. And I found this when I look at the previous instructor's data, and it's not really written. So that like I want to really make sure that like this is what you're doing. So. So as a preparations, here, add a setting. Huh? Oh, let me see, oh sorry. So Y and outcome variable. So you look at this. And then it's just to show the simplest model. It's called a null model. Whatever you hit this, it's going to be just like that. It's a start point. And then you can go other setting and output setting. And then default is this, fortunately, that we reduced the output. If unclick this one, like the, you're going to see much more output data. And then when I look at the first time, I'm almost panicked. So that if we reduce this, like it only extracted most important information that you want to look at. So hit OK, and then run analysis. And when you run, hit the run analysis, you see just like that. Run the model shown, or seven run. But at this time, you can do that way. And if you want to save your data, you can name it and save it. That's what you want to do. So we run the model shown. This. And then DOS display gone. And after that, you start to file and view up. Like that. And after you hit it, you see the output, just like that. General strategy of interpretations of the test of significance for HLM. If you are not familiar, much familiar with the HLM output, the exercise is very straightforward today. But when you run the many factors, it gets very easy to confuse what you're doing. So that's the strategies, how you can understand this. This one, the strategies. So that, like, this is a way you can sync. HLM output checks basically whether or not these gamma, beta, u, and r are zero. And null hypothesis is zero. I guess everyone knows that. And when it's significant, created indicators are not zero. So it means you needed to make the specific indicator this in the formula. But when it's not significant, it means the interpretations, the created indicators might possibly be zero. So let's assume, like, if it's zero, or maybe zero, do you want to include this in your formula? I guess when you calculate, like, 5 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0, you don't want to include the 0, 0, 0 in your formula. So that normally the indicators drop out. But this is tricky things. Like, it doesn't work for all the time. So, but that's the way you want to sync the sync. And a later time, there's some example that, like, the sum indicators are not significant, but we stay. We make it stay. The reason was we take off other models, I mean, the formulas, like level two, there are only, like, for instance, three different formulas, and one formula we don't totally need because all of them are not significant. When we take off all of that, it might just affect the others. So that, like, you don't want to easily take off everything, but, like, that's the way you want to sync. So, for example, the how many people are able to see the view of from your data? Like this. How many? Oh, wow. This is good. So you might look at this one as the most important information, but that you want to look at first. Gamma 0,0 coefficient. And 9. Do you know why it's 9? The reason was, we here look at the groups. So we have 10 groups, not 1,000. That's why. When it's 1,000, like, it's just a normal ANOVA. Like, ignoring the group level. That's why it's 9. And it's significant. So, test the hypothesis, gamma 0,0, coefficient 0, in level 2, 10 groups. So the ground mean is significantly different from 0, which means it's not 0. So you want to include this in your formula. And if not significant, making an intercept gamma 0,0 in level 2, that's the point. It's not meaningful. So when we look at the significant, not significant, sometimes, like, it's too much general word that, like, we start to confuse when you especially see many factors in the model. Like, that's how I understand. Significant means it's meaningful to stay in the formula. But if it's not significant, it's not meaningful. Sure, it doesn't work always, but that's how you want to think as a strategy. And this is the another important output. You want to look at it. Hope, like, now you see your output and find out that. So the random effects level 2 group variance is significant. That's basically what it means. So another hypothesis is that error U0, R equals 0. And it means U0 and R are not 0. Variance components are meaningful. And this is coefficient, so immediately you can put it over here. And this is a decision making. After we see a significant or not significant, I guess you already pretty much know what it is I explained before. So it's meaningful, so it remains in the formula. You can still put other factors. If chi-square values are highly significant. So chi-square, you remember, it's here. That's the chi-square. And then, when this is significant, very high numbers, it means there are still have variables left that may be explained by something else. So when you receive the data from someone else, like someone asks you, oh, could you run the HLM from my data? And you run the simplest model, if you see this high number, it means now you are able to put other things in the model and run them. And when like you put the more variables, the factors, and they're able to be more explained, this number gets generally speaking, it gets lower. So that's the kind of indicator that you want to think. So this is the output view. Sure, we're going to talk about other things in a given day, but today you are at least able to pick up this information, not confused when you see like bunch of the other numbers later time. You're still able to pick up, oh, this is important, this is important, this is important. And then you don't get lost that much. So here, it's just a checking the level 1 units, 1,000. You remember individual, 1,000. The group, 10 groups. And here, it's always show the model. So, check your model. If accidentally you put something else, or you forget to put something, that's the way you want to look at it. And that notations, some of you may have a time to get really used to. Like, that's what I think. If you are already very familiar, I believe you're so genius. So, this you always want to check it. And that, I pretty much explained this. The first, you want to look at this to check whether or not it's significant. And here, as an error value, whether or not making an error value is significant. So what happens if this is zero? It means like there is no error. I mean, like you don't want to totally determine like that, but it's something that you can so now, the answer to the following questions in day one question doc. Sounds like many of you who are already done. How many of you are already done this? Oh, just a few. Okay. Okay, I can explain this. So I already write down this, and it's gonna be blunt later. It's gonna be a little scary for you, but I would like you to fill it out later. But as long as you see R and the U, it's significant. So significant, and this gamma zero significant. So having these guys are. Significant means I interpret the way meaning. So, and this, I write it down as the answer what it is, like score group means error variances in level one, which is just error. Like you can just interpret this error. That's what I do. This random mean. And the U0 error variance in level 2, which is error in level 2. And now we see only just 5 numbers. It sounds like a piece of cake. But later time, you're going to see the da 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 da, and then you don't want to lose your, what you're doing. So this you want to really make sure that, like, oh, that's what it is, that's what it is, that's what it is. And that as a notation, and the list, the chart, like, this is the chart that I created of how you can interpret it, the bunch of the stuff in a, the output. So, blank, 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 and variance components, I already figured out. So data time, here might be blank. And this is the same as this. So, I explained basically what it is. And the chi-square, which is actually comes from here, that considers a high value. Normally, and sure, it depends on like how many subjects in it or so. Like when it's 100 or 1,000, it's considered as a high, really high. So when we see high value, you can continue to put the other factors in HLM. So here, I would like, so you're gonna see this a lot later time. Like I always make this to let you answer, to simplify the so many things in a output. So the first, significant or not, which is meaningful to make this, these guys or not. And the coefficient, like you wanna put this in the formula really, so that like it's there. The variance components, like you want to tell basically what it is, so that like I put here.
So you don't want us to answer the shaded part?
Okay, shaded part. Do you know why it's shaded? Why do you see why it's significant somewhere or not significant in a, the output? You cannot find it, right? That's why. That's why. And you don't find any coefficients in the output.
Oh.
Is that right? So I just crossed out all.
Oh.
So this is helpful that like you wanna start to look at what the values you wanna really look at. Because these numbers, when you look at the output, so you see a coefficient, standard error, TSO, p-value, da-da-da-da-da, many. And if you don't click the reduce sub output, it's gonna be almost double amount. So that is gonna be really hell. So, but you wanna take just only few places, you wanna really look at the first. That's why I crossed out all the things that you are not necessary to look at, because there is no Y in the file, no V0 in the file, but now, not now, so and so. So this is a format, like you're gonna see other questions, at least tomorrow and day four. The places I explained. So, the day three, like you're gonna experience something different. But as long as you do not lose what you're doing from this, you are still able to answer the different form. That's what I think.
So if our if our values for various components and the chi-square value don't look exactly like the example printed out, that's okay, right?
That's okay. The reasons was data simulator.
Yeah.
Like my click, your click, it's different. So that's why. But you don't wanna like be something mine significant, but yours not significant. And then it means like when you enter some numbers in the HLM stem, it may be something wrong. So.
Right. So we just compare significance by the p value, just looking at the actual value. So.
Yeah. Yes. So, how many of you are able to find the coefficients in the output and fill it out the questions document?
Part five.
How many of you are not? I can help you. I can help you also. Okay.
Can you just quickly tell me?
Yes.
How part six is different from part five? Just like it's the exact same thing.
Yeah.
It's exactly the same. But I have more blanks here. Yeah, more blanks here.
So can we just copy the data that we
yes.
put into
yes. part five? You find the values that you want to insert. So this means you don't have to do anything. Like, the reasons you want to really make sure that this is a foundation. So if you forget this sometimes later when a lot of other things comes just like a time and it like even loses what we are doing today, it's going to be gone. So that you want to it's like at least get used to this and make sure I'm able to do this, the stuff in day one. So. So here, okay, I can show you. This is a coefficient.
So maybe that's also G00, is that?
Yes. Okay. So that's the coefficients that you want to put here, just like this.
Oh, okay.
And here, you may want to answer whether or not it's significant. Mm-hmm. And I already write the what it is here, so you can just copy and paste it here.
Takashi, can you review what variance components means as opposed to coefficient, like what that number actually means?
The coefficients, like you remember, like it's together linked with the formula.
Right.
But the variance component is just like that. Just like that. He puts the so this is the value that like you know the whole value and there's some portions the amount that
so the variance component is the error component of the total variance? Oh, no, it's just whatever portion.
Yeah, you can think like that way. So,
but it seems strange to me that those are greater than one, because I was...
Oh, so this is a variance. It's not the correlation. Mm-hmm. So it's not the 0 to 1.
Yeah.
Yeah, you remember variance is already squared.
Okay.
So that, like, it's
oh,
not going
right,
to be
right.
0.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess you remember now.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
When you... when you go back to the beginning class, like it's called 7010 here,
yeah.
7010. Like probably teacher asks you, okay, calculate the variance, and then you square and do this da. That was variance, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you see like normally massive number.
Yeah.
So that's basically the same thing. So that like you see a kind of big numbers. But that one explains basically the portions, but that portions like not as a percentage, not as a percentage.
Yeah. Yeah.
I have a question on that.
But sure, if you wanna compare, like if you wanna know the percentage,
yeah.
You do the same things that like
by
how? Yeah. You already did it.
You can add up all of the variance. Divide each individual one by the total, and that would be the percent of variance that is explained by that.
How do you do R significant
when
the divide table is zero? If your R is not significant, I doubt when you simulate the file, like something may be wrong.
So,
if you don't like
so if you added up all of the variance components, you would have the total essentially variance.
But this means this means this. We are trying to look at the level of
input, whatever it might be.
So that we are trying to focus actually on the
equation.
So when there is no error, even everything is toggled. So that all the points are everything blind. And then like I can tell you a little bit more detail. Like when you don't reduce the output, when you do not reduce the output, you're gonna have a whole bunch. You remember? That one includes the like when the subjects are 1,000. So what level one is a 1,000 model, which is this. Level one, you remember, it's individual. So that like, and then you are basically able to see the same after whether or not R is zero. But like to reduce the output, we don't see it now. Because once we invoke this one and see it, it's panned.
So the 1,000 level one.
No, like you're gonna, you now it's almost 2 pages, right? It's gonna be 4 pages. Because they look at the level one more and run it. But this time we totally ignore it. I wanna minimize the information that I provide you. So that, I don't want you to make confused. So, Do you see the difference? Here, with the robust standard there. And that's, I'm gonna talk about it tomorrow. So that's very similar, so that I would like you to exactly the same as what you showed before. Here. Because this one doesn't have a robust, that doesn't dance. So, but the robust in this case, if you assume like the sum assumptions, you remember that he explained 3 assumptions, like a normality and the independent, like, so that one, if you think it's not met, you can look at this and show it, like it's more robust. It means like, I guess you remember that, like when you take easier, like the 7010 or something, we say significant value or something, and then like significant or not means something like a, we set the bar, and whether or not it's able to jump, you know? So that the robust in this case means we set the higher bar. So it means that if the your analysis comes. It means like you are able to jump the higher bar. It means like your analysis is
three, but I'm afraid to draw all this.
Okay, so sounds like now you understand the logic, and
So, I go the day one
part six, which is doing exactly the same thing. So if you think this is the last one today, if you're totally comfortable that I'm gonna do it the same things on Monday without looking at anything, like, sure you can skip that. This one, you wanna really make sure you are able to do it because the later time it gets complicated. So review of the part four and five. So you remember we made a MDMT file and MDM file running the same data. So that's the data structure. We ignore the treatment effect. And we only look at the group difference and 10 teachers, which means 10 groups. And the level 1, 1,000 subjects.
Same.
But when you go down to the questions, you're gonna see more blanks. That's simplest ANOVA model. You don't even see the color. It means we just 10 groups and 1,000 subjects and run it. So, and this is the model. Level 1 is individual. And that's the formula. Now, end of the day, you cannot really think deep, so you just see and then get used to it. Put it into your head somewhere. And unconditional and conditional, like that's very important concepts. The unconditional random effect means teacher-therapist-school difference. Conditional is gender treatment difference. And now I little bit talk about reliability estimate. When the value gets close to 1, the reliability estimate that you're going to see Monday, it means there might be the variability explained by some other factors. It also means you can continue to test different factors in the model. And tau is variance of all groups from the random mean. And do the basically the same things. So we open the HLM again. And go to the file. And the ASCII input. Yes. And when you push, you see what you're gonna choose. And this is the one click before, in case you lose this. This is the one before here. So if you click this, ASCII input, you're gonna see this. And once you hit the OK, you see this is a little bit of information for you, but what you needed to only look at today is open MDMT file. And this in the ANOVA MDMT. It's again ANOVA MDMT. And after you click ANOVA MDMT, everything is set there like this. So what you needed to do is, this one always very important, that procedure. From make MDM, check status actually you don't need, and it's done. Those two are very important.
So I didn't find that you needed to click done twice. I just clicked it once.
Yes, that happens too. But sometimes it shows like, it needs a STS, da-da-da-da-da. Mm-hmm. I cannot know why this happens, but if you see something like, almost like an error message, but if you just ignore it and then done one more time, and then it just goes through.
Basically, you read the same procedure?
Oh, yeah, now you understand that. Oh. Yeah, this is for the practice. Practice that at least you are able to do this almost automatic. So, and then make MDM. And check status. That one is not needed, but if you push, you see what we are doing.
Oh, really? But our data, our output is slightly different from yours, right?
This must be the single.
Okay. I mean,
output.
Yeah.
Output is okay to be different slightly, but if all of us are significant, but if you see not significant, okay, then I doubt you put some wrong values. Okay. So this is a 1-4. Yes?
Can I see your outcome? Okay, in this, I didn't write down your outcome. This is the
Yeah, that's my outcome. So that you can look at the
outcome. Yeah, my outcome is here. I write down.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
but you don't.
This is based on your outcome.
Oh, no. That one I just demonstrate.
Okay.
I just demonstrate. So that, like, you work for. Your thing. So, but it's a, this is a number. But you don't want to answer from the instructions. Like you work on the questions.
Yeah, this is a question.
Oh yeah, okay. But this, like you see the pretty much similar things in the instructions. If you enter the answers in the instructions, your printing is gonna be really hard. Because it's 40 pages, and you need to look at this. So I don't recommend you to do that. So you work on the question document. And then, so now, done. And you see the formula results. And the Y outcome value. The reasons was, always we needed to look at the what needs to be the outcome. And then, if you push it, you're going to see the simplest model, almost automatic. That's the very convenient functions of the HLM. You are able to see the pretty much the same things in SPSS, but SPSS doesn't do that. You need to use your head to interpret. So, that's one of the good functions. And after that, run analysis and the model shown, and then you see the output.
No. Do we need to put the other settings?
Huh?
Previously, we click the other settings.
Oh, the reason was we just want to make sure to reduce the paper amount.
Okay, but this time we don't.
Yeah, you don't have to because once you check it, it's already.
Oh, okay.
So run analysis and run the model shown and go file and the view output. Today I spend a lot more time, but there are different day, it's going to be a lot faster. So that's what you might want to expect. And go file and view up. Yes.
That means for the two different times the output should be same. It will be the same procedure.
Answer again.
So previously I got output, then now I got it also not output, so it should be the same.
What do you think?
I think it should be the same.
Yes, that's the same. Because we just make sure that you are able to do the same thing.
Okay.
So
thank you.
Yes, later time, we do a lot of different stuff, complicated, so that at least I would like you to make sure you are able to do the things we get done today.
Okay.
So
でもこれでも予定より早く終わってるよ。